My name is Daniel Towsey. I'm known as a truth soldier on the internet. This is a non-scripted, unwritten statement that I'm going to make. As you can see, the title that I've put on this is, "You are so stupid to be undermining the USA." This world is in a lot of trouble. Problem isn't with ideologies, it's not about religions, it's not about races. It's not about countries. We have a huge problem in this world, and the insane have literally taken over this planet and they are killing it. You know, all my life I've watched humanity go from common sense, commonwealth, common law, all based on truth, natural law. I've watched the television programming the children and the adults and brainwashing them. I've seen the school systems change from a system that teaches children how to think, and now they're taught what to think, which is brainwashing. Children are not allowed to voice their intellect in school. I've watched all our food being destroyed with genetically modified organisms and every kind of unimaginable chemical and additive, and you can imagine, I mean, you can't even recognize what's on the labels anymore when you read the fine print. I've watched the oil companies destroying the environment all over the planet. The list of insanity that I've seen unleashed on this planet is endless, because the insane have taken over and the insane have no self-control. They are killing us. They're killing this planet. They're feeding us a bunch of lies on their propaganda media. You know, television, movies, everything. They're instilling division, hatred, making women think that men are bad and vice versa. You've been attacked by psychological warfare all your life. You've never been told any truth from official sources your whole life. And today, the problem that our world faces isn't about a country or even a government, because we have no governments anymore. We've only got corporatism. I've been writing and running blogs and posting and covering protests and doing everything I can to try to wake up the sheeple. It hasn't worked. There's so much going on in this world. And I sit back and I watch and I wonder why it is that people are just not waking up. We got fluoride poison put in our water that sedates people and brainwashes them. You got cell towers everywhere that can alter your very mood, your personality. There's the technology that's been unleashed on this planet, and all the technology is being used to undermine everything that's natural and beautiful about this planet or humanity. And I tell people all the time, the truthers always sound insane when they're trying to tell you what the insane are doing. You all have to wake up and realize that the only power the individual has is to go out and seek truth. Not that truth, but truth itself. I've explained to people the meaning of the word truth, and the word truth by itself is a way of thinking. Truth is an action. For as long as you're seeking it and speaking it, it exists. The second you stop doing that, it no longer exists. Whenever you hear that truth, it's only a moment in time, like a photograph. You can hear about a piece of that truth somewhere in the past or whatever, but that is not truth. It's only a glimpse at something. You need to understand that truth is the only thing that empowers you, you're the individual. And truth is based on common sense. And like I said, I didn't write any of this out, so I'm just speaking to the camera. And I've been trying to figure out a way to wake up the simple-minded people, and I've watched all around me in my lifetime the overwhelming destruction of everything. You've got the Gulf of Mexico that's been destroyed. You got the Amazon that was destroyed by Texaco. You know, I look and I realize that if you turn on your television, there's not a bit of truth about anything. It's all trivia. The IQ level of the shows on television are the IQ level of a moron, of an idiot. And right now, I live in Canada. I'm in Nova Scotia, and Canadians have been fed a lot of bullshit all their lives about how stupid the Americans are and this and that. We've been fed lies about everything. We've been fed lies that the Britain heritage and, you know, the Queen and all that is better. The Queen's nothing. It's just a figurehead. The Queen has no authority. There is no democracy. There is no people's governments anywhere. They're all corporations. Britain doesn't have a government. The people of this world have no governments. All we've got are mega corporations. And they're working on starting a third world war. Look around, go on the internet and find out. This is for real. Go find out about the FEMA camps that are all over the place. They're extermination camps. You go to the website you see on your screen right now, you're going to be overwhelmed at all the evidence of all the truth that's out there. And you might just want to run away from that website and say, man, I don't want to know about Fukushima. I don't want to know about the staged terrorist acts that have been going on in the USA. I don't want to know about anything. I'm just going to go watch some sport on television. I don't want to know that, you know, half the people in the USA are living in absolute poverty. Everybody's collecting food stamps. It's happening everywhere. You're not understanding. This is not about the USA. Canadians have been fed this bullshit that the American people are so bad and they're going around destroying countries all over the world and everything. What you don't understand is the USA was taken over a long time ago when they created the first corporation, which was the Federal Reserve, which was done by the banksters. Zionism is part of one of the names that's been used to describe what's behind the banksters. There's a lot of merit to it because being a Zionist doesn't mean you're a Jew at all. Being Jewish means you follow a faith, a religious faith, which is Judaism. There's no such thing as a Jew except for like a Christian is the one who studies Christianity. Being Jewish is not a race, has never been a race. So get that out of your head. You've been lied to about everything your whole life. You got to turn off your TV, you got to turn off corporate media, you got to start talking to people in your neighborhood, you got to start asking questions, and you got to start getting involved in your society and in your world and ask, why is there poison in all your food? Talk to the guy who owns the store. Say, can't you get us any healthy food? Is this genetically modified? Start getting involved in your society. Get involved in your politics and talk to your politicians. Wake up. Turn off your stupid TV. You're fighting for your life and you don't even realize it. The whole planet is being destroyed. You look at what they did to Libya. Libya was a beautiful, peaceful, happy, fully democratic country operating under a natural law. You go read the Green Book by Gaddafi. Go find out what real democracy is. Libya was the second richest country in Africa because it had a really prosperous, wonderful society that didn't have any corporatism or anyone ripping anybody else off. So they destroyed Libya. They destroyed Yugoslavia based on a bunch of lies. Ever since they created that first corporation, the Federal Reserve of the USA, they've been causing all the world wars, causing all the problems. They've been going around destroying the environment everywhere, destroying cultures and destroying people. Just a massive insanity and destruction is just overwhelming. But you'd rather turn on your TV and think, it can't affect me. Well, I hate to tell you, the insanity is going to keep going until truth prevails and people wake up. Because the only thing that's going to stop the insane is not guns and bombs. It's going to be plain old-fashioned common sense truth. Because if everybody started speaking truth, the person with the, you know, police officer or military guy or anybody who's thinking about pushing a button, killing innocent people, he's going to think twice. He's going to realize when he goes home, he's going to live in the society that he's in. And they're going to ask you, what'd you do? Well, I killed people all day long with drones. Yeah, sat there on my computer screen. I thought it was a computer game. When I was a kid, I was playing all these computer games that were showing me that killing is fun. So I got hired by the government because they came to my door one day and saw my score on Xbox. And they said, wow, man, you're a really good player. You want a job? And you go from having fun playing on your screen thinking that life is a joke and it's all like this. And then you get this job where you're a drone operator. And after a year, you've killed a couple of thousand people. You watch them on your screen and you see the blood squirting and you see them dying. And you know, your brain just, your brain just falls apart. You can't handle it. And in a lot of military guys, people are committing suicide everywhere. Nobody talks about why they're committing suicide, because they've all been brainwashed into doing some really atrocious, horrific things. This is not about countries. This is not about ideologies. This is about the insane banksters are killing this planet. All the bombs they're setting off, all the bullets and everything they're using are all made out of what's called depleted uranium. And it's not depleted. It's absolutely radioactive. And every time they fire off a bomb and they explode something, they're unleashing radiation all over the planet. And Fukushima. Go to my website and go look up Fukushima. Fukushima was no accident. It was all staged and done on purpose, and the plants were actually blowing up. Like I said, truthers always sound insane when they're telling you what the insane are doing. Are you going to go find out what's going on in this world? Hey, do you even care? I doubt it. You know, I have two choices when I go on the internet. I can go to the stupid dumbing down websites that corporations run. And at the end of the day, I haven't learned anything. I haven't enriched myself, and I'm just an idiot. I turn into an idiot. Or I can go to the truther sites and start learning how to think, how to understand what's happening in the world. Look at all the innocent people, all the wonderful people that were all our social leaders that have all been killed, including John F. Kennedy. And the list is endless. Everyone who's an activist who speaks well and only speaks truth is being destroyed. I'm severely disabled from having a car run over me. I live in Halifax, Nova Scotia, and they tried to kill me back in 2009, November 22nd, the same day that John F. Kennedy was killed. They left me paralyzed to a point. They left me pretty messed up, and I don't have much of a life anymore. I sit on my computer, I ride around in a wheelchair. In this town, it's not accessible. I can't take buses anywhere, I can't go anywhere, and the other day, the Zionist guy comes walking up to me. I'm sitting there in my wheelchair on the waterfront, and then he's got a really bad attitude, and he pops it over his shoulder, and he throws me the Star of David, and telling me that I'm really hard on Zionists, that, somehow maybe Zionism is something good. And he thought that my writings or things that I say is, not fair. He wasn't saying a whole lot, but basically when he came to see me about was that basically he said, well, I'm going to pray for you because, basically he's making it clear that they're out to kill me. I know about the Mossad cells that are all over the world. I know what's been going on for the last 100 years. I know how all the key positions in our society have been taken over by your cells, You're masters of deception, and all you're doing is deceiving yourselves. Remember, Zionism is not a religion. It's not an ideology. It's just a covert cover for a name so that you can't criticize what they did on 9/11. What they did at Oklahoma City. And those atrocities in USA and all the other things going on, they're all over the world. Yeah, the sleeper cells are real. Yeah, people watch television and they don't really know the real truth of the danger of this world. It's not the danger you're in. It's the danger of this planet surviving. Fukushima is not under control. It is emitting the most extraordinary amount of radiation you can ever imagine. And it's not just one type of radiation. It's every kind of radiation. Because the fuel they use is called MOX fuel. It's plutonium. The whole Pacific Ocean is dead. It's not dying. It's already dead. This radiation is coming out of Fukushima's nonstop. They can't control it. And anyone who studied it and has paid attention realizes that's going to kill the planet. It's not just Fukushima. You got the goddamn idiots have been going spraying the skies for 25 years with their weaponizing space with their chemtrails or environmental warfare or stratospheric geoengineering. Call it whatever you want. The sky is no longer blue. It's almost white. The horizon is like gold all the time now. Every morning and every night, the whole sky is gold and the sun's gold. It used to be white, the sun, even all the way down to the horizon, but it's not anymore. Do you think anybody watching TV ever looks out their window and says, geez, I wonder why the sun's gold every single day? What's going on with our environment? What happened to the atmosphere? They can't comprehend the amount of insanity going on in this world. That's the problem. They can't comprehend that the situation is so out of control because they've never, ever in their lives ever sought any truth about anything. You've been brainwashed since before you were even born. As soon as they put that television in people's living rooms, that was it. When I was a kid, living in certain places, there was no televisions, and people got along with each other. Life was wonderful. You can go outside and play the simplest game. You play marbles, whatever. And people were really happy because being simple means you're being truthful. So I've watched this world just completely go insane. And the insanity is not ended. You get every imaginable nuclear weapon that's been developed and every other kind of crazy military weapons, and the list of insanity doesn't end. There's a lot of smart people in the world that are aware of what's happening. Some of them actually are taking back China away from the Zionist control. Russia has been trying to clean up the mess that was done to their country. Yugoslavia is gone. Libya is finished. Iraq is finished. Syria is finished. The list doesn't end of all the countries that destroyed. But now when they destroy countries, it's forever because they're using depleted uranium. Go check out all the mutated children that are being born in Iraq. Go find out that there was over 2 million Iraqis that were killed. And then go do some research and find out what Iraq was like before it was ever threatened. It was a wonderful country with a great heritage, great culture, and it was one of the major tourist attractions of the world because of the wonderful culture there and the wonderful people. All gone, all destroyed. Yep, the Americans and Canadian people and everyone was told that the Americans are going to bring them democracy. We're fed bullshit on our media so that when we discover that Iraq's been destroyed, we blame the Americans. We keep hearing the Americans. All there is people, and the USA is undermined by banksters. The UN was created by banksters. Go look at Project Paperclip. Go find out who staffed the UN and the CIA. You start seeking truth and you go to my website here or any of my other websites, the truth is going to overwhelm you. You're going to be lost. You're going to run for your life. You're going to be scared to death because you're not going to be able to handle all this. You're going to give it all up. You're going to go back to being dumb again. You don't need to know all the details of the insanity that's been unleashed on this planet. You just need to know how to think. You need to realize that truth is love. One does not exist without the other. You need to start loving your friends, your neighbors, the planet, the creatures that we share this planet with. But you don't care about anything. You don't care about yourself. You don't care about your wife, your kids. Your kids don't care about you. You've been socially engineered. And with the fluoride and all the prescription drugs they're giving to everybody and everything else attacking you, oh my God, it's amazing you got a brain left in your head. I managed to survive this long because I stayed away from all the synthetic and man-made chemicals and foods and everything else, and I didn't let them brainwash me. I mean, I survived. Barely. But I made it my mission when I realized way back in 1984 when I ran a federal election campaign in Toronto, and I realized that they were rigging the elections. Then I realized, wow, this problem is much bigger than that. It's not about local people or someone in Canada trying to undermine Canada. This is an international problem. They're doing this all over the world. Canada went from being a commonwealth to being a corporatist state. We have no governments anymore. All our governments are now corporations. All our public utilities have been stolen. Our country has been stolen. And now they're raping the environment. They're destroying Alberta. Is the biggest environmental disaster in the world. And it's not just Alberta. They're doing this all over the planet. Can you not get the picture? The problem isn't about you. It's not about your feelings being hurt. It's not about the USA and the American people. It's about complete insanity that's been unleashed on this planet. And that happened when they had the ability to create money out of thin air. The money has literally made them completely insane. And they've taken that fake money and they've just systematically taken over all the wonderful culture and businesses and countries and everything that good humans built. They've taken it over, undermined it or destroyed it or whatever they had to do. And now with all this fake money they produced, they think that they own the planet. And now they don't want to share it with us. Go check out Agenda 21. Go on my website and go check out Agenda 21. It's all about killing everyone and depopulating the planet. I'm telling you, there's no limit to the insanity. We're on our final days. And the only way you're going to save this planet is if every one of you starts loving somebody and loving this planet. And remember, love and truth are the same thing. I wrote a what you might call a poem. I recommend you go read it. It's called I'm in Love and I'm So Happy. This video has been going for 20 minutes and I'm wondering, should I keep talking? Am I wasting my time? Are you even listening? Are you paying attention? So many of you people that I've met in my life that do care give up. You feel completely powerless. I understand what's been done to society to brainwash everyone, to undermine everyone. The plague of our planet is corporatism, and the first corporation was created by conspirators, and they had to come up with a name for their new Federal Reserve, and they called it a corporation. And don't be fooled into believing the word corporation existed before that, because it didn't. But in case you think it did, remember that the Federal Reserve was the first corporation created to take over the world. That's right. And the word corporation was created by a combination of two words. These conspirators knew what they were doing, and they used these two words, and they put them together. And the first word was cooperation. And the second word was corruption. And that's the meaning of the word corporation. If you look at the structure of a business of a how the business plan of a corporation is, it's a crime syndicate. It's mafia. It's everything evil you can imagine. And I've told everyone, take that corporate image that they have all the money in the world to produce that looks so wonderful and peel it away. You're going to see some pretty ugly looking thing. Some people say it's actually the face of Satan you're going to see if you pull the corporate image away. You look at all the shit that's produced in these foreign countries for really cheap labor. You get all these slaves everywhere in China and everywhere producing goods for these corporations for really cheap. And the people in North America and Canadians, I told them a long time ago, I said, you think you're getting a good deal because you're getting cheaper stuff from China or Taiwan or everywhere else? Oh yeah, the products are nice because they shipped out all our factories and they're making the stuff over there with slaves, and then they're shipping it back over here for really cheap. Do you ever ask yourself how the hell they can make money using those big gigantic ships to ship this stuff all over the world? The shipping costs alone should be making it impossible for them to ship stuff around the world like this. You should be making it local. Well, that didn't happen. We lost all our factories in Canada. So did the USA. Everything you look at about corporatism is insanity. All hiding behind a beautiful corporate image. In China, you know, people are put into prisons that are factories. The doors are locked. They have anti-suicide nets around the buildings, because people are trying to jump out of the windows to commit suicide. And the people are kept there working 7 days a week, no holidays, no vacations, no health care, no nothing. You get sick, you die. You get old, you die. They kill you. Don't ever think for a second that communism is a nice thing. And if you wonder where communism came from, go back to the Rothschilds and go ask Rothschild, the first one, that wrote the Protocols of the Learned Elders of Zion, which is Zionism, which is corporatism. Go find out what happened to Russia when they took over Russia, and he killed the Tsar's family, which is a Christian family. And Russia was a peaceful Christian country, and they killed 80 million Christians. Go find out what they did to Japan, where they nuked the only two Christian cities, and they firebombed most of the country for years. Go find out what happened to Germany when they firebombed every single village and town and city. Every night while everyone slept, they killed most of the German population. That was the real Holocaust. Go find out about that. Go find out about when they took over China and brought communism to China, and they killed, the number, 800 million people or whatever it was. But they killed all the leaders. They killed they destroyed all the religions. The destruction is systematic in the world, but what this Rothschild Empire of bankster insanity does is to destroy everything that unifies human beings. It's not about religions. It's not about governments, people's governments. It's about destroying the human psyche that unifies us in the love and the truth and the beauty. And now they want to depopulate the planet, and I am not kidding you. Go check out the Georgia Guidestones, or go type into a search engine, they want you dead as written in stone. You really need to wake up and realize that you do matter. What you think matters. What you say to other people matters. Turn off all corporate sources of information and start loving your kids and start telling them the evil that's been unleashed on this planet, because you're not helping your kids if you don't help yourself. Like I said, the insanity in this world is endless. And I decided that I should write all this out that I'm saying to you, or I'll just narrate it to the camera. And I figured, no, I'll just speak to the camera. You know, I'm sitting here doing my best to try to get you to realize that it doesn't matter what your IQ level is. It doesn't matter what your social standing is in society. All that matters is, do you know how to love? We all need love. That means we all need people to love truth. Not that truth, but truth. Here's a question for you that I've asked many people and they can never answer it. Because truth is always very simple. You've never been taught any simple stuff, and that's why you think you're dumb, because you can't understand complicated things. Truth isn't complicated. Truth is absolute. If you're a scientist or anything else and you're seeking to understand things about the world or the environment or natural planet, you're seeking truth. Truth is absolute. It's undeniable and it's absolute. So everything has a counterbalance in existence. So the further you go from truth, where do you arrive? If you avoid truth and you don't seek it, then you're going the opposite direction. So what's the opposite of truth? What's the other absolute? Insanity is absolute. The insane have taken over this planet. They're killing the planet. They're killing you. They're killing everything. The only thing that's going to save this planet is for you to empower yourself by understanding love and truth. And that's what the message from Jesus was. Jesus wasn't religious, and he didn't like bankers. All he did was go around spreading love by speaking truth to people. And showing everyone that we're all human beings and we're all the same. Whether a person's got a leg missing or an eye missing or whatever, we are all spirits. We all have a soul. And if you look for that spirit and that soul in people, you will find it. If you have a problem finding it, it's because it's been injured. But even if it's been injured by something, whether it's fluoride or prescriptions or man-made drugs that were given away for free to the kids in the hippie generation, with the MKUltra, the CIA did, and the CIA was created by all the ex-Nazis that were brought over, and Nazis were Zionists. Hitler was put into power by George Bush and his family. Zionism is just an extension of the corporatism, which is an extension of the Rothschild Empire. I don't have time to give you years and years of history lessons about the planet. We don't have any time left. This planet doesn't have any time left. This video I'm doing right here, download it, please. Download it, re-upload it, put a different title on it so that YouTube might have a problem blocking it. Put it on different websites. Show me that I'm not pouring out my love here and speaking the truth about everything. And that's it's not all for nothing. Alex Jones is a good guy. He's got a bit of an ego trip, but that's all right. He fears for his family. He fears for the future of this planet. He's doing his very best to deal with all the insanity that he learns every day. And I mean, really, it's definitely overwhelming. The only thing that helps an individual to deal with overwhelming odds is love. So if you think the American people are bad, and that the USA is bad, well, you're wrong. You know, my mother was Native, and we're told a lot of lies. The Natives have been fed lies all their lives. So is everybody else. The Rothschild Empire started, what, hundreds of years ago? And it's all based on lies and deceptions. We were told that 100 million natives were killed in North America. It wasn't 100 million. It was a lot less than that. But it's not just the natives. This Rothschild Empire is killing anybody. The problem in this world is not about people hating natives or hating black people or hating anybody. I don't hate anything. I don't hate anyone. And I told everyone, especially young people, in life, the only thing you need to understand in life is not why things are. You only need to understand what is. Seek what to understand what is happening. You don't need to know why the insane are doing what they're doing. Because if you try to understand the insane, you're going to drive yourself insane. If you try to always understand why, you're going to end up driving yourself insane. That's like saying, why is the sky lit up in the daytime? Why is there rocks on the ground? Why? Stop with the whys and start just understanding a simple truth of what is. Seek to understand what is happening, what has happened. And if you understand what is happening, then you're going to have the power to influence other people around you, and eventually maybe we'll be able to take our planet back. But the time is done. That's it. The final decision that you have to make when you listen to this video is, are you going to be a positive influence from now on? Are you going to be part of the solution? Every individual has to change the psyche and the vibe of this planet to a positive one, because it's going in the negative. This planet is dying. I wrote this little saying a while back, and it goes like this. When the seeds of truth are sown, the grassroots truth revolution will blossom from the Enlightenment. And I'll repeat it slower for you. When the seeds of truth are sown, the grassroots truth revolution will blossom from the Enlightenment. Because if humanity is not guided into the future by truth, then we are all doomed. And this planet is doomed. And that's why they call this the doom generation. So the people that have undermined this planet, the Zionists, the Rothschilds, the Satanists, the Illuminati, and the New World Order, call it whatever you want, because it's a corporate image. They just keep changing their names. But remember that all this insanity was unleashed when they took control of the creation of money. And if you go to my CanadianSituations.wordpress.com site, and you go read the history of the Commonwealth of Canada. Canada is a commonwealth and not a corporation. You go read that. Go see Common Senses. When the Americans, people escaped the tyranny in England that was done by Rothschild, they wanted to be free. But Rothschild never gave up on conquering, and the American people had this great constitution, but it had some hidden secrets in it. That's not democracy, and that's not freedom. Freedom is based on common sense and common law. The Canadians were the only people ever, I think, in the world that ever actually achieved a common law society that worked until Trudeau took over and they started rigging our elections. Go read my report I wrote and put on the internet in 1999 called Corrupt Canadian Elections. Go see how they undermined Canada, how they stole that country. You know, if your body gets affected by cancer, which is caused by fluoride and many other things, there's one thing I can tell you. People talk about God, but I always tell people there's not just one God. The universe is full of spirits. If you empower your spirit by seeking the enlightenment of the power of truth, you won't be alone. Because the universe has spirits, and you are a spirit, but you're a fledgling one. You're just a very young spirit. You want to empower your spirit? You have to seek truth. And when you're trying to help yourself, help will come to you. And if you think that there's no spirits out there and you don't have guardian angels looking over you, if you're a good person, well, you're wrong. And they may kill your body, but your spirit will continue. This planet right now, what I can see, is being killed, is being destroyed. You've got a layer of chemtrail material that's probably a couple of miles thick all around the planet. And it's all different kinds of oxides, different metals, aluminum, barium, you name it. There's no limit. to what they've done to our planet. But the universe has got some pretty powerful spirits in it. And if they feel that there's something worth saving on this planet, and there's the spirit, the sensing that they're getting is that there's good spirits on this planet, they won't give up on us. But if you don't take care of your own spirit, your spirit's going to harm other people around you. I wrote one a long time ago, How to Be 100% Selfish. And I told them, it's very simple. Just give of yourself. And if you give of yourself, it'll come back to you 10 times over. If you learn to love people and care and be nice and walk around smiling and give people a reason to smile every time you go anywhere, if you started giving off positive energy like that, oh my God, your life would change. And eventually, we would, the world would be rid of the insanity, because we don't need to kill the insane. We don't need to bomb and destroy. If truth prevailed in our society, the power of truth alone would stop the insanity. It would just stop. People would just stop cooperating. People would just stop being fearful of the government, thinking that somehow the government knows better. Government is a pyramid scheme. Like the idea there's only one God in the universe, that's a pyramid scheme. That's a narrow-minded vision of the ever-expansive, infinite universe. It's the other way around. Turn the pyramid around. And stick the eye in the ground and set the people free and realize that your power is infinite if you understand the meaning of the word infinity. Go read my article called Infinity. You know, I've been spending years writing different things, teaching people about how to think and what is going on in the world. I did pretty good considering that I'm self-taught and I didn't really go to school to learn to read and write. And I'm French. And I grew up in the Catholic Children's Aid in Quebec, and I was abused more than you can ever imagine. And I saw everything you can imagine. And, you know, the residential schools, I lived there too. I could sit here and tell you of all the horrors that I've seen in my life. And I've been a victim of. But you know, I never gave up on truth. Remember, go read I'm in Love and I'm So Happy. And if you needed me to give you examples of what the horrors are that I've gone through, well, I could, but I won't, because you don't need to hear from me the evil that I've seen. I don't need to acknowledge the evil in the world. I'm sure you're aware of enough of it for yourself. So now at 37 minutes, and this video is going to end pretty soon. And I thank you for listening, but remember that I did this video not for me. I did this video because I love this planet. But when I see all the oceans have been fished out and all the fish are gone, I see all the wildlife is disappearing everywhere. Every time you turn on a TV, it's the most stupid stuff on there you can imagine that completely depraves your mind. The children that come out of school or the girls that don't know how to behave because they don't know how to be beautiful on the inside. The boys don't know how to be beautiful on the inside. You've been corporatized. And all the kids are concerned about is their external appearance, which is the mindset of the corporation. External appearance. And what happens is nobody has any intellect. Nobody questions anything. Nobody wants to look beyond the image and understand the workings of what's going on. If people don't take care of their mental health, then, like I said, our planet is doomed, because insanity, that's the only mental illness there is. And insanity is caused by people who speak no truth and seek no truth. You don't need man-made drugs to fix your problems in your life. All prescriptions are poison. Marijuana, if it's pure and natural and it's done with moderation, it's harmless. But hemp is what you want. You can make clothing with it. You can fuel things. There's all kinds of free energy devices and technology that's been suppressed. Nikola Tesla's inventions have been weaponized. That's what HARP is. That's what chemtrails is. The ozone hole, the ozone layer, which we need to protect us from the radiation in the universe, is being punctured with holes every time a satellite goes up or every time a rocket goes up. We're told heaven is in outer space. It's not. You were given heaven. You were born in it. There's some truth tucked in the light in the Bible. And the thing about the Adam and Eve and the tree is that what you have to realize is that you were already given heaven when you were born. You were born in heaven. And corporatism has taught people to be completely self-centered and selfish, thinking that material possessions makes your life better. You know, today when I go around in society and I'm smiling and I'm nice to people, most women will smile back. Men never smile. And I said to somebody one day, you know, being a genius is pretty easy when you're living in a society full of dumbed down people. I rarely ever do recordings with my camera like this. And I may never do another one, because every time I go out in my wheelchair in this town, there's people that are trying to kill me. And there's no protection for me here. There's no law here. There's no democracy. Nova Scotia is 100% corrupt. Halifax. There is no government of the people here. There's no commonwealth. There's no nothing. We call this the doom generation. So, you get all this Fukushima radiation now that's coming over North America, and it's spreading. Actually, it's coming around the whole planet. But remember that Fukushima is still emitting huge amounts of radiation. I think somebody said that every hour, that was a few years ago they said this, a couple of years ago, every hour, the amount of radiation coming out of Fukushima is equivalent to 10 Chernobyls every hour. Now it's even worse than that. So, you know, if you were to go out and read my stuff about Fukushima, it would just scare you to death. If you read about Oklahoma City, about 9/11, you would just feel so overwhelmed and so powerless and think that there's nothing you can do. And you'll just want to bury your head in the ground and think that I'm going to hide from the truth. I'm going to hide from all of this. And I'm just going to live my life the best I can. Doesn't work that way, guys. You don't need to know the workings of the insane's mind. You need to follow your spirit and guide your spirit and empower your spirit. And if you empower your spirit, you're empowering other people's spirits. And that's the secret to life. Fix your spirit. Start learning the meaning of the word love and the meaning of the word truth. Because that's the only thing that's going to save our planet, is for you to seek and speak truth or say nothing. Turn off your televisions. Stop looking at corporate-produced anything. Whether it's on a little screen on your cell phone or wherever you get it from. Corporatism is the plague of the planet. You know, YouTube censors my videos. They censor my view counts on my channel. I've done other truth videos before. But when I go to separate pages and look at the numbers, they're in the thousands. And I look on my own website, I go to my front page on my YouTube, and the number's really low. And I go, that's not real, because it's not possible. YouTube, whenever there's an activist online that has a video that a lot of people watch, YouTube will give it really small numbers of views so that everyone thinks, well, no one's paying attention. The more important it is, the smaller the number is going to be. You can't trust corporatism. If you start getting in tune with your spirit, you're going to start loving life. You're going to start loving people and then loving this planet. You know, you can close your eyes and you can sit somewhere and you can tell when someone's looking at you. That's your spirit. You can sense their spirit. The more you learn to develop your spirit, the more you're going to realize that it's very real. You had a spirit before your body came into creation. The universe, you know, we hear talk about aliens. Of course there's other life forms in the universe that are intelligent. And of course there's life forms out there that have evolved, you know, hundreds of millions of years and billions. But the only life forms that achieve pure energy of love is spirits that are pure in truth. And there are all kinds of living beings in existence that are different than us. The evidence is there. You can see it on the NASA videos. You can see it on websites. You can see the orbs flying around our planet. You can see all kinds of stuff. Those are spirits. But God is a spirit, and there's not just one God. The universe is limitless with spirits. And here's the secret to power and energy and strength. The basic, most basic equation of math, which is basic reasoning and logic. Here's the very most, the very basic, the core of it all. If you have a positive and you have a negative and you put them both together, what do you always end up with? And nobody knows the answer. It's amazing. I never meet anybody that has the right answer. Positive has energy. Negative has nothing. If you want to be a positive person with positive energy and give off positive energy, you have to pick and choose when you give off your energy. And if you're giving it off to a negative entity or Satanist or whatever you want to call it, all they're going to do is drain you. And that's what's running the world today. Everyone's living in fear. Everyone's following the orders of this pyramid scheme masters up there. The masters of deception, which is what the Mossad does. That's their motto. If you believe the story about the Holocaust, well, I hate to tell you, well, it's not what you've been told. If you do enough research, you realize you've been lied to about everything in your whole life. The internet was born in Toronto. At the tail end of the hippie generation, hippies had this idea that we need to have a means to transfer truth around the world. And that's how the internet was born, in Toronto. And a guy created this very basic little mechanical device, or, you know, digital, call it whatever you want, but it just was a code machine that could send text messages anywhere in the world over a telephone line. The hippies created the internet, the concept of World Wide Web, and made it in a way so they would stay free, and it's still free. For those who seek truth, it's there. And don't let anybody tell you that the internet's full of idiots. I hate to tell you, but idiots don't know how to push a power button on a computer. The internet has lots of corporate sites. And if you stay away from corporatism and you go out and start seeking the truth sites, you're going to find them. And you're going to realize they're all interconnected. And that's the World Wide Web. Every truther site has links to other truther sites. But if you follow your spirit and you guide it, whatever your spirit needs to know, it will discover. That's the amazing thing about being spiritual. You don't need to know what truth is, because you're blind. You're blind until you find the truth. When you get empowered to the power of truth, you're literally blind, because you've been living in the darkness until you've seen truth. So you don't need to go to a church to seek the secret of what Jesus was telling us. Jesus is everyone's brother. He went around spreading love and truth, and empowered people, and told everyone, I don't want you following me. I just want me to be setting the example for you. And every religious thing you've ever read about Jesus, well, it means nothing, because none of the books or anything or anyone ever wrote any of this stuff ever met him. And the story about Jesus doesn't go back 2,000 years. It goes back over 15,000 years. And the pyramids aren't 5 and 10,000 years old. Some of them are millions of years old. They don't want you to know about the history of the pyramids, because they don't want you to realize the history of Jesus goes back a lot further. The stuff you see written on the hieroglyphics in Egypt on the pyramids there were written by people that didn't build the pyramids. They couldn't even get in them. Even today, we still can't get in most of the pyramids. Pyramids were there millions of years. Some of them are hundreds of thousands of years old. There's evidence of previous lives on this planet all over the world. I don't know how many pyramids there are, but there's got to be like 40 or 50,000 pyramids all over this planet. They're everywhere. So I'm at 49 minutes right now, and I'm just giving you a bit of a highlight that I think now maybe you realize that, wow, if what I've just been telling you, even 1% of it is true, your mind's got to tell you that, wow, that means you've been lied to about everything else your whole life. Pick your truth and go find out more about it. Pick any topic you want. If you care about the fluoride poison, go do something about that. Pick anything you want. Be a positive energy. Be a positive force and go out and speak truth. Time is running out, guys. Ladies, children, everyone. You run in fear, it's not going to work. You bury your head in the ground, you're just going to be sticking your ass up in the air, and you're going to get screwed up the ass. Sorry for the expression, but that's the way it is. I don't want to bury my head in the ground for anybody. What else can I say? What else can I say? UN Agenda 21. World depopulation. You know, when I found out the 80 days and 80 nights they bombed Yugoslavia to oblivion, and I looked and did some research, and Yugoslavia was a beautiful, peaceful Christian country. Germany was a beautiful, peaceful Christian country. Russia was a beautiful, peaceful Christian country. China was the most fantastic country in the world that had been around well over 10,000 years and had never gone around conquering other countries. Iraq never attacked anybody. Iran never attacked anybody. There's only one plague in the world, and it's hiding under Zionism, which is corporatism, which is insanity that was done by Rothschild. Go find out how Rothschild took over England by creating Napoleon Bonaparte's army and going around destroying countries and stealing their wealth. And it's been the same agenda ever since. They destroy and then they go put in the central banks and they indebt everybody to the financial system. And it's just the insanity and the lies, it just never ends. But the planet can't handle this anymore. You got all these mega corporations out there that control everything. Don't be fooled to think you have a government anywhere, because there isn't any. They're all corporations. And there's a rule in crime. There's no honor amongst criminals. And the criminally insane are killing this planet. Now you know what's going on. You go to my website, go see about the nuclear bomb that Obama tried to ignite in the USA. But it wasn't the kind of nuclear bomb you would expect. It was a type that would knock out all the electronic and electrical and computer, and it would just completely shut down the USA completely. And they were supposed to do that back in November, and good people in the military took the nuke and took it out in the deep ocean and ignited and blew it up. People with conscience, okay, and people that love and care can make a big difference. It's the only thing that ever makes a difference. Are you going to be part of the solution in this world, or are you going to just keep burying your head in the sand and being, what? Idiots that think that destroying the USA is the answer?